Hey, Tom here from the Run Testers. In this video, we're going to be taking a look at the latest 361 Degrees Feisu 2 running shoe. Feisu 2 is the upgraded version of the previous Feisu, if I'm pronouncing that correctly. Feisu is the Chinese word for fast, apparently, which will come as no surprise when you find out that these are lightweight racing shoes. Although it looks fairly similar to the previous iteration, there's actually a few updates to the shoe which are actually fairly nice. It comes in at 204 grams for men in a size 9, it's got a 9mm drop, and it'll cost you $120 or €120. Everything about the Feisu 2 is designed for speed and kind of stripping down a shoe to the bare essentials to make it faster and lighter. But that doesn't mean that they've skimped on features to make this a nice running shoe. One of the main updates that's been made to the shoe is the outsole section. So at the top, there's additional blown rubber added to make more grip and more traction. And at the back here, there's a durable carbon rubber heel for more stability and kind of support as you're running. The upper section has this sort of thin, breathable mesh. And they've also added something called a more fit kind of stability section in the midfoot section of the shoe here to kind of strap your foot down and make it feel like it's really held in place. Another feature is it's called an anatomical tongue, and that's designed to, it's kind of like a tongue that's got cushioning in the central section as opposed to being over the whole section. So you've got more kind of comfortable support in the areas that need it. In terms of the looks, I'd definitely say it's the nicest looking of the 361 Degrees shoes that I've ever seen. I think I mentioned in the previous review for the Spire 4 that I've never been a massive fan of a lot of the designs from 361 Degrees, but when I saw this one, instantly I thought that looks like a nice shoe. It's kind of got a nice retro feel to it and just looks like it's just a really nice colourway. So yeah, I'm a big fan of the way this shoe looks. I've been wearing these for about 70k of running so far. I haven't done any racing in them because there's no races at the moment, but I have done quite a lot of speed work in them. I've actually ran my fastest ever 10k time in these, knocking about a minute and a half off my fastest 10k. So I got about 38 minutes in this. So yeah, they're a fast shoe. I really like the speediness of them. At a time where most new exciting shoes are all about carbon plates and new technologies in foam, it's quite refreshing to find a shoe that is more about simplicity and kind of taking stuff down to the bare minimum when it comes to features to make sure that it's lightweight and just allows you to really pick up the pace without any need for lots of technology. That said, even though it is like a racing flat, there's still a bit of cushioning in there. It's kind of like a higher level racing flat with this 9mm drop, which makes it kind of like a nice entry level way of getting into lightweight, more racier options. And you do notice that when you go running, there's not a lot of cushioning in it, but there's enough to make it more comfortable than what you'd expect from something with this weight. Although 361 Degrees have pared down the features on this shoe to make it lighter and kind of make it really simple and speedy, they haven't taken away everything, and there's some surprising features on it that still exist, which make it quite an interesting shoe. The outsole, there's quite a lot of rubber on that for such a lightweight shoe. It offers quite a nice level of durability. After 70k, there's very little signs of wear and tear on these, so I think it's probably going to be a fairly durable racing shoe to have. There's quite a lot of stability in this heel section, And in addition to this kind of more fit stability area in the midfoot, it does hold your foot in place really nicely. Having said that, they are, for me, they fit fine. The front section, the breathable kind of mesh at the front, my toes do press out of it a bit. It's not really an issue because of the way the material's made, but I have noticed that that central section could be quite restrictive if you've got a wider foot. For me, it fits perfectly. I don't have particularly wide feet, but if you did have a wider foot, I think that might start causing a bit of an issue. The front, there's lots of room in the front foot, aside from some around the sides where I do find my toes pushing out a little bit. It's definitely a race shoe. I've done a few training runs in these, and they're great if you're only going out for speed, as I found as I was trying to break my 10K time. For training, definitely not enough cushioning. I wouldn't use these for training runs, just for racing. I'd probably say that they offer a really nice chance to move into faster racing shoes for people who don't want to go full flat. So for 10Ks, shorter distances, half marathons, I'd probably use these and expect to get to find to be a really nice shoe to pick up the pace with. For a marathon, for me, there's not enough cushioning. I think I find that lack of cushioning a little bit jarring as the race goes on, but if you're used to less cushioned shoes, these are probably going to be fine. Overall, I'd say this is a great piece of kit if you're looking for a really lightweight shoe. You don't want to go all the way to racing flat. You want a little bit of cushioning. Maybe if you're looking for your first kind of really lightweight speed shoe. And it'll offer a great opportunity to see what it's like to run in a light shoe. It's an all-round nice option. There's good traction, there's good stability, it's comfortable. It's just a really nice, simple shoe that does the job when it comes to lightweight speed. Alternatives for me would be something like the Adizero or the new Adidas SL20s. The SL20s are actually quite similar in terms of the weight and how they feel, but this does have more cushioning. So the SL20s are noticeably hard at the bottom. These are a little bit nicer. So if you're thinking about that speed shoe, then these are probably a better option if you're worried about losing the cushioning, because you'll still get enough from this if you're racing. So that's it from me. Thanks for watching. Leave us a message in the comments if you have any questions, if you want to know any more about the shoe. And don't forget to like, subscribe, and click the little bell that makes you get notifications about when we've got new videos coming up. Catch you later.